Students, today's session is on application of enzymes in food industries. Enzymes are the most useful catalyst in industrial applications. We know that. Enzymes perform specific significant reactions essential for the production process with ensuring the quality of the end product. Enzymes are biocatalysts used in industrial production of various food products with required characteristics based on the purpose and need. Especially enzymes are used in modification, extraction, brewing, reduction, filtration and fragmentation etc. of various foods to ease in enhancing the flavor, color, texture and appearance. Commercial food processors and manufacturers are using diversified and immobilized enzymes to produce specific and convenient food products. Enzymes have been playing an important role in food production since ancient times. Production of whiskey is one of the ancient examples for enzyme usage in food industries. Nearly all commercial food products nowadays contain at least one enzyme which was used either in processing or preservation. Some of the familiar enzyme applications are in the production of bakery products, chocolate syrups, pre-cooked cereals, infant foods, fish meal, cheese and dairy products, egg products, fruit juices, soft drinks, alcoholic beverages, vegetable oil, puree, candy, spices and flavor extracts, sweeteners and liquid coffee, as well as for dough conditioning, chill proofing of beer, flavor development and meat tenderizing, etc. The important objectives of today's session is to know the need and importance of enzymes in food industry and to learn about various applications of enzymes in food industry and to aware of the enzyme regulations in food industry. Okay, first let's see the need and significance of enzymes in food industry. So, we know that enzymes are important biocatalysts in food industry and they all utilize a variety of enzymes for processing of various foods in food industry. Numerous benefits are obtained from enzymes uses in food industries which could not achieved with regular chemical treatment. The resultant benefits are high quality products, low production cost, low wastage, minimum energy consumption and biodegradability. The degree to which a desired technical effect is achieved by an enzyme can be controlled through modifying various factors such as dose, temperature and time. A relatively small amount of enzymes are sufficient to accomplish a reaction as enzymes are catalyst. For example, I'll say one example. An enzyme preparation in most food users is equal to 0.1% or less of the food product. Enzymes are not present in the final food product as most of the enzymes are generally destroyed during food processing. Okay, let's see the sources of enzymes which are used in food industry. Since all living cells produce enzymes, they are obtainable from plant tissues, animal tissues and microorganisms. The enzymes produced at industrial level from plant and animal sources are very considerable, but for both technological and financial reasons, microbial enzymes have been becoming increasingly important. Plant enzymes have great industrial importance, but a very high amount of plant material is required for the production of enzymes in small quantities because the enzyme recovered efficiently from plant is very, very low. Animal enzymes are byproducts of meat industry, hence their supply is limited and other users compete for enzyme yielding tissues. In the case of microbial enzymes, if we consider, there are no limitations in production and supply as in the case of plant and animal enzymes. Hence, the production of microbial enzymes is increasing to meet the demands. Further, the types of enzyme availability from microorganisms are almost unlimited. So now let's see the application of enzymes in food industry. Recently, if we take 20th century, in the 20th century, enzymes began to be isolated from living cells, which led to the wider commercial production and application in the food industry. Recently, enzymes are used in various applications of food industry like protein and starch processing, processing of raw material for alcoholic fermentation and dairy, etc. Okay, let's see the applications of enzymes in each individual industry. If we take the baking industry first, bakery products are common food products throughout the world, and appearance, freshness, taste, flavor, color, etc. are few of the quality criteria that the consumers expect from the bakery products. Therefore, baking industry need enzymes as one of the process aid to standardize the quality, and hence enzymes are very essential in a range of baking applications of the industry. In baking industry, enzymes are used to process consistently high quality products by enabling better dough handling, obtaining anti-staining properties, and controlling over crumb texture, taste, color, moisture, and volume. Chemical supplements that were used in baking industry are being replaced by enzymes in recent years. For example, chemical oxidants such as bromates can replace by the enzyme oxidase to strengthen the gluten. In processing of biscuits, crackers, cookies, and other crisp bread dough, enzymes are added often to other grains to weaken its gluten. The findings from many research studies have shown that enzymes can improve the performance of the flour and flour behavior in many baking applications. Optimum adjustments have to make according to the application of flour and respective cereal age in the store. Now we will see the application of enzymes in confectionery. Invertase is used in candy industry generally for the production of cast cream centers, rolled cream centers, and liquid fruit centers such as cherry cordials like. In each case, its use is based on desire to obtain a semi-soft and liquid consistency at sugar level, which will prevent fermentation. Invert sugar syrup containing more than 79% of sugars fulfill both requirements. Invertase has a pH optimum between 4.5 and 5.5, which is satisfactory for most users in candy industry. Invertase for use in candy industry is prepared from yeast by plasmolysis followed by digestion with proteolytic enzymes. Commercial preparations usually contain the enzyme in 50 to 60% glycerol or 70% sorbitol solutions. In the chocolate industry, the use of dairy ingredients contribute significantly to the flavor of the confection. Such flavors can be obtained by the use of cultured butter or by fats modified through the addition of the enzymes. In practice, whole milk is modified by treating with esterase, and the material is spray dried after lipolysis. The resulting powder corresponds in overall composition to whole milk powder, and it can be used at levels of 0.5 to 3% in the manufacture of chocolate. Next, enzymes uses in milk and dairy products. So there are many products where the enzyme is used for the manufacturing and during processing. The first one is the cheese, because it's very important product where enzyme uses is more in cheese industry. In cheese making, you know, rennet, an enzyme mixture, is an important element which is obtained from the stomach of the cows and other ruminant mammals. Chymosin A purified form of the enzyme in rennet is synthesized microbially from genetically modified microorganisms without the need of sacrificing the young animals and available in the market. This chemosin performs same function as the chemosin isolated directly from the cows. So, enzymes are also used to improve the cheese flavor. The varied flavors of cheeses incorporated into number of applications or obtained due to the action of enzymes called lipases. Lipases act on the butter fat in cheese to produce distinctive flavors that are characteristic of different types of cheese during the ripening stage of production. Specific flavors to the various cheeses are obtained by the application of specific lipases, which are responsible for the development of respective flavors. And another important product is lactose-free dairy products. Lactose-free dairy products. Do you know what are lactose-free dairy products? These are specialty products manufactured for lactose intolerant people. In these individuals, generally, lactase, an enzyme, is either absent or not present in sufficient quantity, which occurs naturally in the intestinal tract of the children and many adults. The milk sugar in dairy products such as milk, ice cream, yogurt, and cheese is converted into digestible sugars, glucose and galactose, in the presence of lactase. But in the absence of lactase, the lactase can lead to undesirable side effects in the intestine. Dairy industry now introducing a variety of products using commercial digestive enzyme lactase, and the products are labeled as lactose free. These lactose free dairy products are developed as a result of pre-treatment with the enzyme lactase during processing of milk itself or production of final dairy product. These lactose free dairy products are available in the shelves of medical or functional food markets. Lactase is also available at retail for use at household level in treating lactase containing dairy products. So, coming to other proteases, in addition to the caseins, milk contains a number of different types of proteins. Denaturation of proteins using proteases is required in manufacturing of many products. For instance, destruction of whey protein is essential for cheese production. Then denaturing of whey proteins results in a creamier yogurt product. Proteases are used to hydrolyze whey protein, which is broken down into shorter polypeptide sequences. This hydrolyzed whey is used to prepare supplements for infant formulas and medical users, as it is less likely to cause allergic reactions. Coming to applications of enzymes in beverage industry. Enzymes are used widely in the disintegration of fruit pulp and the clarification of juices and wines. In the fruit juice and wine industries, enzyme decreases processing capacity and improves economy. Fruit and vegetable juice specialty enzymes are pectinases that contain hemicellulase enzyme activities. Pectinases are most frequently used enzymes in food industries, as they facilitate to increase juice yield and accelerate juice clarification. They produce clear and stable single-strength juices, juice concentrates, and wines. Proteases not only increase juice yields, but also increases the color extraction and juice volume, as well as functional antioxidants in fruit and vegetable juices. Starch and pectin content in raw fruit and juices can reduce by the action of pectinase and amylase, and thus a clear, stable juice and juice concentrates are produced. In wine production, many biochemical reactions are enzyme catalyzed. The enzyme activity initiates during the ripening and harvesting of the grapes and continues throughout fermentation, clarification, and aging of the wine. During winemaking, the manufacturer supplements the commercial enzymes with natural grape enzymes to obtain a clear and stable wines, as well as to increase the production capacity of the wines. It also supplements to enhance the body, flavor and bouquet, etc. Pectinase that contains hemicellulase enzyme products are added to grapes or sometimes mast to increase free run juice volume and extraction of the color, fermentable sugars and flavor components, as well as reduce pressing and fermentation time. These enzymes facilitate to improve the flavor, texture and color of finished wine. Beta-glucanase containing pectinase depectinase grape must prior to fining and filtration during fermentation or in young wines. Wines made from overripe grapes infected with Botrytis cinerea mold and often difficult to clarify and filter due to high concentration of this mold produced glucan polysaccharides. A beta-glucanase containing pectinase is also used to degrade Botrytis glucan, and beta-glucanase containing pectinase can speed up clarification and filtration. Acid proteases clarify and stabilize some wines by reducing and removing naturally occurring and yeast synthesized heat labile proteins. Now let's see the applications of enzymes in brewing industry. In brewing industry, especially in beer production, enzymes are extensively used. Enzymes reduce the viscous polysaccharides like xylan and glucans occurred in the beer by acting as filtration improvers. In the manufacturing of the light beer, enzymes remove the carbohydrate present in it and induce chill proofing. During the phase of fermentation in beer brewing, yeast converts the simple sugars present in raw materials like barley, maize, sorghum, hops and rice into alcohol and carbon dioxide. Majority of the raw materials used in beer brewing is plant-based, which contain complex polysaccharides that yeast is unable to convert. Malting is the traditional food processing technique used to break down these complex polysaccharides. However, malting process is expensive and difficult to control in large-scale industrial processing. This problem can be controlled by adding enzymes to unmalted barley. The enzymes can act on complex polysaccharide that broken down to simple sugars and reduce or eliminate the costly and complicated process of malting. Enzymes can also add to the beer in post-fermentation period to induce maturation rapidly. Now, we will see the applications of enzymes in coffee and cocoa. In the process of making natural coffee, the presence of mucilaginous layer which surrounds the coffee bean makes the drying quite difficult. Coffee made with this process is often inferior in quality. The use of enzymes for the liquefaction of the mucilage of the coffee cherry is based on its content of polysaccharides, which are susceptible to the hydrolytic action of the pectic enzymes, hemicellulases or cellulases. Since commercial pectic enzyme preparations contain appreciable concentration of these and other enzymes, the use of this process for removal of the mucilage could be worked out. The process of liquefaction of mucilage can be completed in 1 hour at 24 to 25 degrees centigrade if 0.2% of a commercial pectin enzyme preparation is used. In this process, the skin and fibrous pulp is removed mechanically and the enzyme is then mixed with the pulped beans. After liquefaction of mucilage, the beans are washed with water and dried. So, similar process for cocoa bean has also been recommended. Coming to modified starch. Sweeteners derived from starch is often using as cane or beet sugar replacers in food industries throughout the world. The enzymatic treatment of starch has become much more popular than acid hydrolysis. The treatment of starch with enzymes results in a variety of sweet syrups which are commonly used in food and beverage industries. There are three stages in starch modification. Liquefaction is the initial process where amylases liberate maltodextrin. Maltodextrin contains dextrins and oligosaccharides, which are very mild in sweetness. The subsequent process is saccharification. In saccharification, in which the dextrins and oligosaccharides are hydrolyzed further by enzymes such as pullinase and glucoamylase. The saccharification process converts all the limit dextrins to glucose, maltose, and isomaltose. The resulting syrups during saccharification process are moderately sweet, hence the need to modify further. Glucose isomerase treated glucose or maltose syrups converts a huge proportion of the glucose to fructose, which is sweeter than glucose. This isomerization process results in syrups with approximately 50% of fructose and 50% of glucose, and such products are most frequently used as sugar replacements in food industry, in the manufacture of foods and beverages, which are known as high fructose syrups. Next, we will see the meat industry, application of enzymes in meat industry. Meat tenderization is carried out in a number of ways, either physically or chemically, to decrease the proportion of detectable connective tissue without causing damage to microfibrillar proteins. Application of proteolytic enzymes has become one of the most popular method of meat tenderization. Treatment with proteolytic enzymes in meat industry is due to their effective action on wide range of temperatures and pH. The enzymes most often used in meat processing industry are pepain, bromelain, transglutaminase, and much lesser extent ficine derived from fig tree for meat tenderization. Enzymatic applications based on pepain are mostly used in meat industry. Pepain is an enzyme from papaya, acts in protein hydrolysis as a catalyst and resulting the breakdown of meat fibers, which are very tough in nature. Bromelain is a group of proteolytic enzymes, degrades microfibrillar proteins and collagen similar to other proteases. Bromelain is widely available in present in large quantities in fruit leaves and stems of the bromelaceae family. Among the pineapple is the most familiar. Transglutaminase is an enzyme generally used to enhance the functional properties of the protein, such as texture, flavor and shelf life. And the most significant use of transglutaminase is the ability to induce gelation in meat products. So now we will see the miscellaneous applications of the enzymes. Several applications which could not be grouped with any of the preceding product classifications are: the first one, the removal of atmospheric oxygen from packaged foods by glucose oxidase. Secondly, the broad area of digestive enzymes for clinical and dietetic use. This area is closely related to use of enzymes in feed industry. Finally, the treatment of fibrous foods with the enzymes in order to improve their digestibility or extractability. Next, very important aspect with regards to food industry is enzyme regulations in food industry. Globally, the market for food enzymes is rapidly growing, worth about $1 billion. The food enzymes availability and kind of application with their annual turnover is continuously increasing for many years. The Association of Manufacturers and Formulators of Enzyme Product enlist approximately 247 enzymes manufactured for the food industry uses as of April 2014. Since many years, regulators, policymakers, consumers, and public were not focused on the enzyme uses by the food industry. But the situation has changed with regard to the application of genetically modified microorganisms. Awareness was created and health consciousness has been increasing among consumers, and the consumer group and environmental supporters were alarmed by the production of enzymes with genetically modified microorganisms in the beginning of 1990s. There is a difference with regard to food additives and processing aids in food legislation on food enzymes. Okay, let's see what are the food additives. Food additives are the substances or a mixture of substances other than basic foodstuff which is present in food as a result of any aspect of production, processing, storage or packaging. The term does not include chance contaminants, whereas processing aids do not have any technological effect on finished food product. For instance, all food enzymes are regulated as food additives in Canada, USA and Japan. Whereas in Australia, food enzymes are considered as processing aids. The safety evaluation of enzymes has been conducting by the Joint FAO and WHO Expert Committee on Food Additives since 10 years before the SEF guidelines. The committee meets to elaborate the principles for evaluating their safety, conduct a toxicological evaluation and establish acceptable daily intakes or tolerable intakes. Next, prepare specifications for purity of the food additives. And the last one, assess the intake. Students, let's summarize the session once again. Enzymes are important biocatalysts in related to food industry as they perform specific reactions essential for food production and processing. In food industry, enzymes has been using in various applications such as bakery, cheese making, starch processing, production of fruit juice and other drinks, etc. Enzymes are needed to standardize the quality of the products as one of the process aids in food industry. Hence, enzymes are rapidly becoming very essential to food industry. The food enzymes availability and kind of its applications with their annual turnover is continuously increasing for many years. There is a difference with regard to food additives and processing aids in food legislation on food enzymes. Joint FAO and WHO Expert Committee on Food Additives has been conducting safety evaluations of enzymes since 10 years. The application of enzymes in food industry results in various benefits, often include high quality food products and low production cost and low wastage, minimum energy consumption and biodegradability. Thank you.